Kim from Kim's Upholstery here. Today we'll be upholstering a king-sized headboard. Today we'll be working on a king-sized headboard. The frame has been built, it's been padded out with foam, and now we're going to put on our Dacron, which is our next step. We've got the Dacron attached with a little bit of spray glue just to kind of hold it in place, and now I'm going to trim it to shape and then we'll staple it. So I'm going to start at one end and I'm going to staple the Dacron right to the top edge of the plywood here. Pulling it taut as I go to kind of soften that edge of the foam. So every so often you want to just check with your hands to feel if there's any lumpiness going on that you can adjust. Now we'll work down into this curve. Now we're working down the side to the leg. I'm going to trim off that excess. Okay, the Dacron's all on and trimmed, and now we're going to lay it on its back to work on the next part. Voila, we have fabric now. Now I just get it positioned, make sure I've got enough everywhere for what I need to do. So I've got my fabric positioned where I want it, so I'm just going to gently use my hand, curve the edge of the foam and Dacron, and start stapling the fabric down. And you're probably saying, why the heck is she stapling those staples on the front of the headboard? But later we'll cover them up. And I will go in and fill in more once I get this all attached. So the bottom's anchored in place, and now we're getting ready to come to the top and pull it around and staple it here. Just getting a few staples spaced apart, and then we'll go back and fill it all in later. Again, you want to keep checking, make sure you're keeping it fairly smooth. So now my top's pretty well anchored, and then I'm going to go up the sides. Now there's a boxing that's going on here, so that's why I'm stapling in this flat surface. Okay, now I'm going to go do the same thing on the other side. Okay, now we'll start working in these curves. Now we're ready to put cording on. So I'm going to line it up with the edge of the cording resting right along the edge of my plywood and start stapling it. I'm going to get it anchored along here, and then we'll go in and fill it in afterwards. Again, feeling for the edge of that plywood, keeping it right nice against there. Now I'll trim away this excess fabric. And our next step will be to put a boxing strip with cardboard on here. I've got a long boxing strip here that's going to go along the top. I've marked my center point here, and I've marked my center point on the headboard. So I'm going to line those up. So I'm spacing these quite a ways out because when I put the cardboard tack strip over the top, we'll fill it in. I'm going to continue all the way down the curve and down the side of the headboard. Now this is where we're going to put another cardboard tack strip and flip this down. Okay, so we've got our fabric laid down, and I've got my cardboard tack strip, and I know that I need that to be 4 inches up from the bottom. So we'll get it into position, push the cardboard strip up there. And we'll do this in a few places to get started. And then we'll go back and fill it all in. Now pull it down and take a peek. Looking good. Now we'll pull it underneath and staple it. Now I'm going to cut going along the leg and stopping in the corner where my brace is there from my back. Now we'll pull this taut. Get a couple staples in here because the leg will get covered up after. And we'll take this part that we've cut and pull it back around to the backside and staple that down as high as we can go. stand her back up. Now we're ready to put the cardboard tack strip on. Line it right up tight to our cording. Space them out first time around and then we'll go back and fill it in. So now we'll fold it back and take a look at it before we fill it all in. Much easier to make adjustments with less staples, so. And it's looking good. Our cardboard tack strip is all in place. We've pulled up our fabric and checked it, and we like the way it looks. So now we're going to put some Dacron on here to soften the wood and pull it all to the back and staple it down. And I'm stapling inside the Dacron, not on top, because I don't want a dimple effect. So I just lift the top area and staple inside. You'll notice I'm spacing these probably every 2-2.5 inches. They don't need to be real close. Now we're going to continue the Dacron down through these curves and down to the leg. Okay, the Dacron is all on and now we're ready to pull the fabric up. I like to start in the center and work my way to the corners. So I'm going to get a staple right in here. I'm just getting a few staples for now and then I'll come back in and fill it in and keep it all consistent. Now what I'm doing with my fingers up here too is keeping the Dacron on that and not letting it come down the front or the back edge here, because it'll be in the way later with my cording. And this is where you want your staples really close together so you don't get a bunch of variance in the height. The top is done. Now we're going to work in the curve section here. And do yourself a favor that you don't do something with this design if you've got a fabric that doesn't stretch, because it won't be fun. This is where it pays to have sharp scissors.
Please be sure to check out our Kim's Upholstery YouTube channel for part 2 of this video, closing the back of the king size headboard, and more videos on upholstery, window treatments, and upholstered headboard.
Sometimes they bite.